So now today we are going to be discussing some other concepts in JavaScript. So let me start with a different kind of DOM operations. How we are going to be working with document related things. Okay, so from this document, how to access element, how to access class, how to access ID. And later on, we will provide some events on particular type of elements or IDs and classes, each and everything we will discuss one by one. And first one, the first concept is very important concept, how to access. Okay, then let me tell you document.getElement by ID. Document.getElement by ID. So what this particular method can be? And what is the benefit of this particular method? So for example, if I want to access any ID from HTML into JavaScript, I need to follow, I want to follow below method. Yes, so how to follow this particular method, just we want to go with. For example, there is some paragraph which is going to be available here. Okay, this particular paragraph is having something like ID. ID is called one. Okay, so this is a hello para. I want to access this ID in the JavaScript. Let me write a JS now. So this is HTML. Let me write very, very clear. This is HTML. And in HTML, there is one paragraph which is having some ID. Okay, let me have some other element like H1. I'm going to be having another element called H1. And H1 is having some ID called 2. This is having ID called 2. Paragraph is having ID called 1 and H1 having ID called 2. I want to access this particular element first. How to access that particular element? document.getElementById. Very, very clear. And this is case sensitive and camel case we have to follow. getElementById is a method. Each and every method in JavaScript in camel case. document.getElementById and ID name we need to provide. ID name is what actually one. Something you have to go with. Suppose I want to update HTML, I want to update CSS, I want to change some operation on this particular ID. I just want to access the ID in this particular manner. For example, if I want to access the second one is H1 tag, and that is containing an attribute called ID again 2, and this one is called 2. ID name is very, very clear. So whatever the ID 1 which is going to be available here, the same ID 1 you should pass here. Very, very clear here. So here ID name is 1, right? That one only I need to access here, and here ID name is 2. 2 only I need to access here. So am I clear this to you?
Yeah.
Okay, so let me do work on the first project, first application. This is what access element. Okay, let me store your project now. Day 13. Inside the day 13 folder, I want to create a application. I want to create a simple application. access ID.html. This one is access ID.html. Okay, so access ID. Let me write simple paragraph over there. So there is one simple paragraph which is going to be available. Hello para. This is my para over there. And this particular paragraph having some ID called one. This para having one ID called one. What my requirement is, I want to access this ID. How to access the ID? Very simple. So first of all, write a script. So this is my script. Inside the script, I want to implement some code. What is the code I want to write for this? Go to the script and
script is not coming off the body. Slash body.
Please tell me.
Yeah, I told you that this script is coming before the slash body or after the slash body.
After the close tag of the body. We need to write the end of the body.
Okay, sure.
You need to write end of the body. So whenever the body is going to be closing, so I just want to write a script. I will tell when I will write a script on the top of the body or on top of the head section, what is happening, I will tell. Okay.
Okay.
And document dot get element by ID. So this is camel case and case sensitive. Element by ID. What is the name of the ID? We need to provide in the single quote or double quotes. Okay, so I want to access in this way, and this is only accessing process. But my requirement is I want to show some content of the ID. What is the content of the ID? Inner HTML. I want to access inner HTML. Inner HTML is a JavaScript method which is going to be accessing the HTML of your ID. What is the HTML of the ID? HTML of the ID is hello para.
Yeah.
Okay. I want to access that particular inner HTML from that ID. So what I want to do for that? So I will prepare a variable where x equal to something, where x equal to. This is like a right and left. Right value passed into the left variable. So your variable name is x, and you are taking the value from the right. So you have the value in the right. What is the value in the right? We are accessing the inner HTML of the one and passing that value into the X. And finally, what my requirement is, I need to show the alert box here. So alert X, that's it. And open the browser. So whenever you open the browser, you can see something that page says hello para. Hello para is the inner HTML from that particular ID we are accessing here. Very, very clear. So from this particular paragraph, I got access to x value. Fine. I want to update the x value now. X equal to something like hello JavaScript. So hello para, I want to change to hello JavaScript. And again, I want to show the alert box. And that will be again x. What it is going to be happening now? Very, very clear. When you open the page, hello para is the first alert. And immediately you can see hello JavaScript. What is happening? Mm-hmm. JavaScript is executing a step-by-step process. JavaScript always executing step-by-step process. That is a very, very fundamental point we should remember. Okay, JavaScript always step-by-step process or step-by-step execution. JavaScript always step-by-step execution. So first alert is what? Okay, first alert is x value, and first 13th line will execute. 13th line is what? document.getElementById1.html value is going to be accessing here. What is happening in this particular way? So something is going to be happening. X equal to hello para. Am I right or wrong? Something is going to be happening there. X equal to hello para. And finally, after updating the value of the x, after updating the value of the x equal to now hello JavaScript, something is going to be updating, right? Am I clear?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. After updating the thing, alert again showing. So here line by line execution. 13th line will execute first, 16th line will execute second, and 18th line will execute third, and 21st line is executing at the fourth step. Step by step execution. JavaScript executing step by step. JavaScript always step-by-step execution, line-by-line execution, step-by-step execution, nothing but line-by-line execution. Line-by-line execution. We have to remember all these things, okay? I will show the notes also. Okay, let me see what is happening with the alert. Again, I want to execute the same application. What is happening? Hello para, we got it. And hello JavaScript, we got it. Now, my requirement is, I want to update the paragraph text with the hello JavaScript. I want to update the paragraph text with hello JavaScript. Now I am writing the one more line after the alert box. document.getElementById1.innerHTML is equal to again x. Again x. See what is happening again. So finally, whatever the text we got updated, that is going to be storing in the inner HTML again. So I don't want to show the alert boxes. Just hide the alert boxes now. So alert is hiding. What is happening? Very, very simple. First of all, we are accessing the inner HTML of X here, and X is updating with some other text, and document dot get element by ID one again inner HTML updating with X. So this is actually left to right assignment. Here again left to right assignment. So finally assignment will be what? Finally output will be what?
JavaScript.
Just hello JavaScript.
Yeah.
See inside your code you are writing. Inside your code, you are writing in the body hello para, but finally with the JavaScript we are doing some manipulation. That manipulation is simply inner HTML equal to something like a X. Okay, so instead of taking all this code, what I want to do is directly I will put something document dot inner HTML document dot get element by ID of one dot inner HTML is equal to hello JavaScript. Can I do like this?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a direct process, single line code. Instead of writing all these particular lines, I am doing something. What I am doing? One simple line code I am writing. That simple line code is very simple. Document dot get element by ID at ID is one. Inner HTML is equal to hello JavaScript. That's all I know. Okay, that's fine. And you can see now, so you can able to update and you can able to see on top of the thing hello JavaScript. Let me check. Go to the inspection. Go to the first button here in the inspector. Go to the first button. Yeah. Click on this, and open your HTML. Inside your HTML, basically, hello JavaScript paste. Can you see this?
Yeah.
Hello JavaScript paste. But in the code we are writing what? Hello para. In the coding we are writing hello para. But after updating your JavaScript, what is happening? After updating code, what is happening? Hello JavaScript taking place. Okay, can yes. I do some changes now? I want to apply some color for that hello JavaScript. How to apply the CSS for that? Again, you can write something hello document dot get element by ID dot inner HTML. Okay, dot CSS dot style dot style dot color. Okay, color equal to something like a red color. I want to show. Okay, this is actually DOM manipulation again, but we are applying some CSS. We are applying some CSS for that inner HTML. That style will be a color red. Okay, now you can see. Okay, finally color got updated. So when here the color will be, so we can't able to see the color. What is the problem of the color? Okay, let me check. What is the problem with the color? Just go to the console. I don't get the color. What is the problem there? Inner HTML dot style dot color equal to red. First of all, save that thing properly. Okay, so style dot color equal to red. Okay, style dot inner HTML dot style dot color. Okay, that's it. Inner HTML. I don't want to go for the inner HTML directly. The element got style dot color. Now you can see.
Yeah.
Finally, I'm accessing the element. That accessing element, whatever the element we got accessed, that element in the color red. Can you see that now?
Yes.
Okay. I want to make some more CSS for that. I just want to make align to the center, and I need to provide some background color. Okay. So let me take a common code. Copy the code again. Document dot get element by ID one dot style dot text align. Text align equal to center. See, basically in CSS we are writing in the different way. How in CSS we are writing? Text hyphen align. This is in the CSS. This is in the CSS, right?
Yes.
But coming to the JavaScript, that will be in the camel case. This is in the JavaScript. Whenever you want to update the CSS in JavaScript, you should write camel case one. So what is the camel case here? Text align. But in the CSS, what you can do? Text align. Text hyphen align, right? For example, if you want to change a paragraph alignment, how to write paragraph alignment? Text align, something like a left. This is right. This is in CSS. This is in CSS text align. But coming to the JavaScript, that the text align property got updated with the camel case. You got it, okay?
Yes.
Now you can see that okay, text align setup. That's all got applied. And one more thing I want, I just want to apply some background color for that. How to do apply some background color for that? background okay color, background color equal to something like yellow color I want to apply, but the same background color in CSS and JavaScript, same background color in CSS and JavaScript. How to do background color in CSS and JavaScript? In CSS, background color will be like this. In JavaScript, the background color will be like this. Is it okay?
Yeah.
Now you can see some background color got applied. Okay, finally done. So I got my element updated with the JavaScript. Some JavaScript manipulation is happening. Some JavaScript manipulation is happening. With the JavaScript manipulation, we got something. That something will be, we are accessing the ID. Through that particular ID, we are doing something. This is the way of accessing the elements in JavaScript. Accessing IDs in the JavaScript. Is it clear? Everything fine?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. The next concept is very simple. How to access tag. How to access tag. So we just want to get understand how to access tags. So this is the document.getElementById for access ID. This is the accessing ID. Is it okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Now I want to follow the next concept. Next concept is very simple. How to access elements. Instead of taking IDs, I want to access the elements now. Okay, document.getElements, this is a plural, by tag name, and I want to pass index here. And this is accessing tags. Tag or tags, whatever it may be. Tag or tags, one tag or multiple tags. This will be tag or tags. Why? Because ID is singular, tag name is plural. ID is singular, tag name is plural. Okay, I don't provide a multiple ID or same ID for multiple elements. Okay, one more point I'm writing. We don't provide same ID for multiple elements. We don't provide a same ID for multiple elements. And here very simple is we can access multiple ID at the same time. We can access multiple ID with the array index. This is very, very important. What is the concept here? Document.getElements by tag name of index. For example, I'm going to be having multiple paragraphs over there. In my HTML. So let me type multiple paragraphs. So these are the multiple paragraphs in the HTML. And inside the JS, how to access those particular paragraphs. Now tell me how to access all this.
You can access by ID.
Yes, no.
Documents, get elements.
By tag name. Document.getElements by tag name. Okay, now we don't have ID. Just imagine we don't have ID.
Okay.
I don't have ID right now. Then document.getElements by tag name. Tag name is what? P. P of zero means only first paragraph you can able to access.
Yeah.
And I want to access the second paragraph. I want to access the third paragraph. P of one, P of two. Is it fine?
Yeah.
Okay, I can able to access all the paragraphs right now. Okay, let me tell you, I want to access H1 from that. Okay, hello heading. I want to access this H1 now. How to access the H1? Please tell me.
Document dot get element by tag.
Tag name. What is the name of the tag? H1.
H1. Yeah.
Of
zero.
Exactly. So H1 of zero. Only one H1 is there. Even though only one H1, you have to pass the index value. If I am having one more H1, then tell me how to access the second H1.
Yes, one. Just change the last.
Exactly. Index. If I am having something like H2. Hello, another heading. how to access the second H2, how to access the first H2 here. Only one H2 is available in the body. How to access the first H2?
Documents.getElements by tag name, H2. Index 0.
Index up?
0.
0, exactly. So that's it. This is the way of accessing your elements. This is the way of accessing your elements. How many elements are there? We don't care about it. But if you have the same element multiple times, you need to check your index is properly giving or not. If you are having one element, even though one element is available, for that particular one element also, we should provide the index 0. Index, without index, we can't do anything for the plurals, like class names or tag names. Class names and tag names are plural things. ID is only singular. For ID, what we are doing? Element by ID. Here it is very simple, element by ID. But here it is elements by tag name. That's all enough, okay? Can I take access tags now? Let me take a new program. Save it, access tags dot html. That's it, enough, okay. Access tags now. How to access tags? Let me provide multiple tags over there. Okay, can I take multiple tags now? Can I take all these tags? Body, inside the body, I'm having multiple tags. Now try to writing the script now. Okay, what is the script of that? This one is right. Okay, document dot get elements by tag name of p of 0. Okay, p of 1, p of 2, p of h1 of 0, h1 of 1, h1 of 0. Okay, can I put all these things console.log? What is console.log? Yesterday we discussed about console.log. Console.log is?
The string is in console.
Yeah, sure. That's it. Console. Console.log. Please check the syntax. If you have the syntax issue, automatically it will show the syntax issue. I will show the syntax issues for you. Even though one simple syntax will gone, one character will gone, automatically you will get a syntax error. Automatically you can get syntax error, okay? Can I switch off all this? Okay, now you can execute the program now. What is the output now? Hello para, hello para, hello para, hello heading, hello heading. Go to the inspection. Go to the console. We have the syntax issue. What is the syntax issue? Which line we are getting the problem?
Accessing the tag.
Accessing tag. Somewhere we got the problem. In which line we got the problem? 21st line. We got the problem in 21st line. What is the problem with the 21st line?
Yeah, you close.
By seeing the code, you can understand. Code, you can understand. After argument list, something is missing. Some parenthesis is missing. So provide parenthesis properly. Whenever you provide parenthesis properly, then only you can see the output. Otherwise, you can't able to see any outputs. Okay, sir. We are giving these two correct, right?
Yeah.
Even though you're getting an issue with this particular third line, we are getting issue with the third line. First line, second line also not executed for you.
Okay,
this is the debugging process of JavaScript. So debugging is very, very important in JavaScript. Whenever you got an issue, automatically check the issue, resolve the issue. Without resolve the issue, we can't able to do work on that one. Okay, remaining all the things are possibly done, but this is not working properly. Automatically we got the issue. So that issue can be identified by the console and we got the procedure very, very clear. So what happened? So this first paragraph we got accessed, second paragraph we got accessed, third paragraph also we got accessed. But I want to access inner HTML only. What is the inner HTML now? I want to access only inner HTML. I don't want to access the tags. So then what is the inner HTML for the first paragraph? Hello para is the inner HTML for that. Is it okay?
Yeah.
Okay, second paragraph, third paragraph, automatically we are getting the text. Okay, so I want to go with the inner HTML every time. I don't want to access the complete element dot inner HTML. That's all enough. In the same way, you can put this one also. Okay, paragraph 2, document dot get element by p of 2. So paragraph 2 also done. And now this one will be h1, that is already done. Okay, if you want to access document dot get elements by id, tag name of h1 of 2 is there.
Yeah,
h1 of 2 is there. Can I go and check it out?
Yeah,
console.log. Please check once. H1 of 2 is available or not?
No.
We don't have.
No, we don't have.
Only two H1s are there. H1 is having the 0 index.
Zero,
second, yeah. H1 is having the 1 index. But one. Where you have the 1, where we have the 2 index?
Mm-hmm.
Where we have the 2 index, correct? So we don't have any 2 index. You're having syntactically problem. Okay, let me check the output now. So unfortunately, instead of giving 0 and 1, you are providing 2. What happened?
Undefined.
So it is not giving issue. It is not going to be making you error. It is procedurally going to be making you undefined. Undefined nothing but, sir, whatever you are saying in the console.log, that is not defining. You not defined that one. Okay, can I go for the first one?
Yeah.
Okay, in our HTML, can I see now what is the output of this?
Hello, heading.
We got it. Okay, so manipulating. So how to do manipulation? For example, I want to make it this one to center. So text align equal to center. I want to make it style to center. How to do that? So that's it happened. Can you see? Second heading going center.
Uh-huh.
Second heading going to center.
Yes.
In this particular way you have to do. For example, I want to go all these paragraphs making center. So in this particular case, what you have to do is you need to write a loop now. I will tell you loop later. Yes, so we are not in the loops right now. For loop, we need to provide for where I equal to 0. Okay, I less than document dot get elements by tag name of p of I. So now I is the index now. I, then I plus plus. I will tell you the loops later. What is happening now? Document dot get elements by tag name of p of I for each and every paragraph. Dot style dot css equal to sorry style dot text align will be equal to center. So at the same time for all the paragraphs I want to make a text align center. At the same time for all the paragraphs I want to apply the color will be red. What I want to do for that? Dot color will be red. Can I do that?
Yeah.
Yes, check it out. So loop is running now. Okay. So okay, so I equal to 0, I less than document dot e dot length, 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 I plus plus. Now you can check it out. Now you can check it out what is happening. All the paragraphs got aligned center text. Now I want to apply one more style for that. Okay. Document dot get elements by tag name pfi dot style dot background color. Background color equal to something like yellow, okay, light blue. You can see that now. How it was run. All the paragraphs at the same time, style got applied. How we are applying all the paragraphs at the same time? Some style is applying for all the paragraphs at the same time. What I am doing now, so I am just simply writing a for loop here. So there is an index initialized with a 0 and index less than document dot get elements by tag name of length. Length, what is the length of the paragraph? length starts from 1. So I will tell you the loops now. I will tell loops later. Okay, what is the length of the paragraphs? What is the length of the paragraphs? How many paragraphs are there? Length nothing but how many?
You mean the number of the yes. number of letters?
Yes, how many? How many paragraphs are there? How many? 3.
Is paragraph, it mean paragraph or it mean the letter?
Yes, how many paragraphs? That is called length. How many paragraphs are there?
3.
So length is 3. Index. Index starts with? Index starts zero. With 0. Correct. Length starts with 1. Length starts with 1. Index starts with 0. You have to remember that one. Okay, what is the syntax of the for loop now? For where I is my variable actually. I equal to 0. Index initialized with a 0. And I less than paragraph dot length. I plus plus I increment. Okay, in this loop, what is happening? In this loop, what is happening? Very, very clear. In this loop, something is going to be happening. What is happening? First time, what is I value?
0.
0. 0 less than length of the paragraphs. Is it true or not?
It's true.
Condition is true. Whenever condition is true, some code will be executed. Okay, 0 is passing here. P of 0 dot style dot text align. P of 0 style dot color. P of 0 style dot background. Okay,
I
now
plus plus.
Next I plus plus. I is incremented by 1. Then I is equal to 1. 1 less than document dot get element by tag name. Is it true or false? See, this is something like iteration. First condition is true. I equal to 0, condition is true. First I equal to 0, initialization value is 0. So when condition is true, what is happening? Some block will be executing for you. Some block will be executed. Block of the code will execute. Then again, I increment. Block will execute.
We can use if also.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of loop, we can use the if condition.
What condition?
If.
If. No. This is not if condition. If condition is a separate manner. If he is checking only true or false. But this is loop. Loop is iterating. Number of times that particular block should be iterated. Number of times this block should be iterated. See, understand first. So my screen is visible, right? My drawings. Okay. So first of all, initialization I equal to 0. I equal to 0. 0 less than length of the paragraph. Condition is true or false. Condition is true, then block will execute, then I plus plus. So when block is executing, some style got updated. For zero style updated. For zero index style updated. Next I plus plus, I is incremented by 1. Now the value checking with 1. 1 less than paragraph index length.
Mm-hmm.
1 less than document dot get elements by tag name of p dot length. 1 less than length. One, what is the length actually? Length is 3, right?
Yeah.
1 less than 3. Condition is true or false?
True.
True. And block is executing. One related code will update.
Next, I
incremented again. Then second time 2. 2 less than 3. Condition is true or false?
True.
Whenever condition is true, 2 will be executed.
If we have 4 paragraphs,
if you have 4 paragraphs, so it will print all the 4 paragraphs for you. See, finally it is going to be checking the condition with the length. See, first time 0 less than 3, condition will execute. 1 less than 3, condition will execute. 2 less than 3, condition will execute. Finally 3 less than 3, condition is 3 less than 3, condition is true or false? 3 equal to 3, right?
False.
3 equal to 3. 3 less than 3 is false. So automatically loop is terminating.
loop is stop. Okay.
Yes, loop is terminating. Terminating nothing but stop. See, first time 0 less than 3, code block will execute. Second time 1 less than 3, code block will execute. 2 less than 3, code block will execute. 3 less than 3, condition false. Automatically, loop is going to be terminating. Okay, don't worry. I will give you the flow diagram also for this. Okay, I will give you for loops, and there are different kind of loops available: while loop, do while, and for loop, and all. And I will give you the very very clear architecture about the loops and all later. Okay, don't worry about the loops right now. But just understand how the things are happening here. Just understand how the things are happening here. Okay, instead of writing the loop, what I want to do? Suppose I don't have the loops right now. For example, I don't have the loops right now. Then what I want to do? I don't have the concept of loops right now. Okay, just to switch off the loops now. I don't have the concept of loops now. I want to make align all the paragraphs center alignment, and I want to make a color will be red, and I want to make. Okay, so just what I want to do now, please check it out.
Yes.
Okay, so again, see what is happening now. 0 0 0, that's fine. 1 1 1, that's fine. And 2 2 2. So this is actually a bloody code. Actually, we don't write this type of code. This is like a hard code. We don't write hard code in this manner. For the zeroth paragraph, I need to write CSS. For one paragraph, I need to write CSS. And second index paragraph, I need to write CSS. This is hard code. Instead of writing a hard code like this, what I want to do, I will write a smart code. What is a smart code with the loop? Got understand? Okay, this code will execute. Okay, no problem. This code will execute and all the paragraphs got updated, but this is hard code. Instead of writing a 9 lines of code, what we are doing here? We are writing a simple loop here. Whenever I write a loop, all the paragraphs at the same time you can able to execute. You can see that?
Yes.
Okay, you have a lot of paragraphs now. For example, I have completely 9 paragraphs available in my HTML, or I have 12 paragraphs in my HTML. What happened? All the 12 paragraphs, you can see the same one. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay, now you can tell me the condition. Now I want to check the condition. If document dot get element by ID tag, if I percentile 2 equal to 0, what is percentile 2?
I don't know.
Percentile nothing but, I will tell you operators later. Percentile 2 is actually giving a remainder. Remainder is 0. It is even number. I percentile 2 is nothing but it is even. Even paras. Check the condition for the even paragraphs. Check the condition for the even paragraphs. Even paragraphs, I want to go with the light blue color. Odd paragraphs, I want to go with the yellow color. Even paragraphs and odd paragraphs. Okay, now you can check what is happening. Now check out what is happening. Even paragraph, some color is applying. When I percentile 2 equal to 0. Okay, so first I value is 0. Let me tell you. Okay, 1 percentile 2 equal to 0. What is percentile 2? Percentile 2 equal nothing but, so whenever you are actually multiplying with the 2, you need to get a even number remainder. Remainder value is going to be checking. Remainder value is going to be giving 0 or not. Okay, for example, there is something like 5. And I want to check every time 2. 2 2s are 4. And what is the remainder here? What is the remainder value?
1 1.
Whenever you have the remainder value 1, automatically this will be odd number, right? Okay, now I want to divided by 2. 2 twos are
2
and 0. What is the remainder now?
0.
Whenever the remainder is 0, this is what? 4 is what?
Even.
So in this manner you have to check it out. I percentile 2 equal to 0, nothing but whenever you are making percentile and you are getting the remainder value is 0, then it is the even number. Even number paragraph, whenever you come, go with the light blue, and other all paragraphs go with the yellow. Am I clear?
Yes.
It's a simple logic, actually. Simple logic, even odd logic. Any confusion till now?
I'm not saying the zero value. I percentage equal to 0.
I percentile 2 equal to 0, nothing but whenever you are dividing with, suppose 0 divided by 2 equal to 0. So first of all, I value is 0. First of all, I value is 0. 0 divided by 2. 1 divided by 2. And 2 divided
percentage
by
2. Percentage means divided. I mean the percentage.
Percentile, nothing but you need to get remainder value. We need to check the remainder value here. Check the remainder value. Percentile is remainder. Here percentile is remainder. Percentile value is remainder value. Okay, now I'll ask one more question. What is 5 percentile 15? What is 5 percentile 15? Or sorry, 5 percentile 3. Now you tell me 5 percentile 3. How to do this one? So 5 is your original value, right?
Yeah.
And you need to make operation with the 3. 3 ones are 3. What is the remainder here? 2. So 5 percentile 3 equal to what? 5 percentile 3 equal to 2. Am I clear? Okay, 15 percentile 4. What is the output of this? 15 percentile 3. Percentile 4. What is the output of this? 4 goes in 15. How many times? 4 threes are 12. 4 threes are 12. And what is the remainder there?
3.
3. Output is 3. Now, you got to understand how percentile is going to be working. Percentile is going to be providing you remainder value. Okay, now you tell me 100 percentile 5. What is 100 percentile 5?
20.
No. Remainder value. 520 is 100, right?
Yeah.
Remainder value is what?
Okay, let me calculate 5.
Remainder value 0.
Yes.
Okay, let me tell you one more thing. Okay, so okay, so 100 percentile 5. What is the value?
0.
Okay, so 45 percentile 3.
Zero.
Yeah. 3 15s are 45, right? 7, 6, 7, 8, 8 5s are?
5.
8 5s are 40. 8 5s are 40, right?
Yeah.
What is the remainder?
5.
Yeah. Five. So percentile is remainder. Percentile is remainder. Okay, so 45.
It will multiply that value.
Yes, exactly. So 45 percentile 2. Okay, 2 goes how many times in 45? 22 times. 2 yes. 22s are? 2 22s are 44.
44, yeah.
And what is the remainder then?
1.
Okay, 7. Yeah, 3 is the remainder. 3 is the remainder. Okay, so 9. 0 is the remainder. Why? 9 5 is a
5.
9 5 is a 45.
45.
9 5 is a 45. Then finally, remainder value is?
Okay, it's not 0.
0. So you have to get understand how the remainder value is going to be working for you. Okay, so this is percentile. I will tell you the operators later. Don't worry. Don't worry. I will tell you operators later. Is it clear everything?
Yeah.
Don't confuse. Here we have to get understand only the simple thing. What is that? Percentile 2 equal to 0. So here you are having I value number of times coming. What is the I value? Number of times I value is iterating for you. I value is going to be iterating number of times to you. 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's all. So number of times I value is coming to you. Number of times I value is coming to you. So whenever you got I value number of times, each and every time, it is going to be checking the condition. First of all, 0 percentile 2 is equal to 0. That is fine. Okay, 0 percentile 2. What is the 0 percentile 2? Now let me go to the calculator. Don't confuse, okay? First time, y value is 0. What is the 0 percentile 2? 0 percentile 2 is equal to? Okay, now go with the 1 percentile. 1 percentile 2 is equal to? Okay, so it is going somewhere. 1 percentile 2 is equal to, this is not coming up, banner. Can I go here? 0 percentile 2. What is that?
0.
1 percentile 2. 1. 2 percentile 2. 0. 3 percentile 2.
1, 3, 1.
Okay. 4 percentile 2.
0.
5 percentile 2.
1.
1, obviously. 6 percentile 2.
0.
7 percentile 2.
1.
Okay. 8 percentile 2. So, what is even number? What is odd number? All even numbers actually remainder 0. All even numbers remainder is 0. All odd numbers remainder is 1. That is a fundamental logic. Okay, that is a fundamental logic. Is it clear?
Yeah.
That's it. So in this manner, I want to just provide in the CSS and colors. There's a way we are providing the CSS and colors.